Hey, what's up YouTube? Scott coming back at you with another video. It's kind of late on Tuesday night. I'm kind of up in my desk area, an area where I'm not usually at. But I got a couple slabs here to go through. Before I do that, I'm gonna kind of go through a couple things I have kind of up here by my desk area. So if you just bear with me here. Here's one of the photos I have. It's a signed photo by Paul Horning, Jerry Kramer, and Fuzzy Thurston. Sorry if there's a little glare there, but need some light on it. This is from the Mud Bowl 1965 NFL Championship game on January 2nd, 1966. Packers beat the Cleveland Browns. I believe this was actually Jim Brown's last game. Just an iconic piece right there. Kind of neat. And above that, have my Green Bay Packers Incorporated stock. Pretty cool. And over here, have a Forrest Gregg signed canvas. This goes really well with that Mud Bowl picture. I believe it is from the same game. Iconic picture of Forrest Gregg. Look at that face. It shows that time in the 60s where men were men. So cool. Love that piece. Alright, so just gonna go through a couple of slabs I got in over the past week or so. Actually got a baseball card in to start. 1972 Topps Jim Slayton rookie card for the Brewers. This goes with my PSA all-time Brewer set on the registry. Population of only 15. Picked this up in an auction for fairly reasonable. First one of these I've seen come up in quite a while. That's just a set that I'm slowly working on. Not as adamant about that set as I am my football stuff, but it's slowly chipping away at it. I'm about 50% complete in that Brewer set right now. There's the back. Kind of a cool card. And then I picked up a couple of football cards after that. Non-Packers, actually. 1977 Topps Mike Webster. This goes with the NFL Top 100 Players set and also the NFL Hall of Fame set, rookie set. Mike Webster is played for the Steelers, of course, as a center, NFL Hall of Famer. But the main reason I got the card is because, let's see if they show it. They don't show it on top, but there it is. Attended the University of Wisconsin-Madison. I do collect a lot of the former Wisconsin Badger players. A few notable ones are Mike Webster, Elroy Crazy Legs Hirsch. I have one of those cards as well. Also a Hall of Famer. Arnie Herber, an old school guy from the 30s, is another one. Here's another guy, not an NFL Hall of Famer, but former Heisman Trophy winner Alan Ameche from 1955 Bowman for the Baltimore Colts. Got the new Lighthouse PSA hologram on there. Picked it up in grade of an 8. Beautiful looking 8 too, just awesome centering. Colors are deep red, rich colors. I love this 55 Bowman set. There's the back. Again, born in Kenosha, Wisconsin. Attended University of Wisconsin. I love the little verbiage on the back here. The horse was the Colts' first draft choice! Exclamation point. Everybody's All-America fullback and winner of the Heisman Trophy as the nation's outstanding football player. The personable Ameche is a sure shot to win stardom in the pro ranks. With Zoli Toth, he gives the Colts what many say is the best 1-2 punch at fullback in pro football. A great competitor and a real team man, Ameche should have a great year in his rookie campaign. Pretty hilarious that they're touting the double fullback punch here. You know this is a blast from the past when you start hearing about multiple fullback sets. But yeah, awesome card. Happy to get that one. And then another card, which a lot of you will know. I know I'm a huge Packers fan, but if there's a Bears card to get, this is the one. Just a beautiful example of 1976 Topps Walter Payton rookie card in the grade of an 8. Definitely one of the most iconic football cards, in my opinion. Gotta respect Walter Payton on and off the field. Was a great guy and just an outstanding player. And there's the back. Main reason I picked up this card is because eBay's been offering so many deals lately, it's almost making me go broke. With a 20% discounts on anything, there's another 15% discount offered today, actually. I honestly couldn't find anything else more to buy. I kind of cried uncle, and I was like, all right, I'm done. I can't buy any more stuff this month. So, but this one got a pretty good deal on it. The centering on the back is really good. That's another one thing with this card to look at. You can find the centering good on the front, but the back is usually a little off. So I ended up settling on this card here. So, pretty awesome card, Walter Payton. This goes to the top 100 football players and the top and the NFL Hall of Fame rookie set as well. Also the top 250 cards in the hobby set, which is a set that I'm very slowly working on as well. So, very cool. I've got another NFL Hall of Fame card coming sometime this week, but I just kind of wanted to make a video tonight, go through the what I got so far. So, pretty neat. Really happy to have this card, the grade of an 8. Shout out to Jack Frost Football. I know I've seen a couple Walter Paytons in the back of his videos, so I'm sure he'll appreciate this card. Also, Bears 9 McMahon, Jack. Now I just got to get you guys to pick up some Packer cards and we're all good. Alright, well, I hope you guys enjoyed the video and just seeing a couple of things hanging on my wall and a couple slabs again. I am expecting a couple more cards this week, so hopefully this weekend I'll get a chance to make another video. I am also expecting to get another card display case for my wall. Picked up a pretty nice one, again with one of those eBay discounts over the last couple weeks. That should be in, I am guessing, beginning of next week. And that's one of those big card display cases. I already have a couple, but what I'm going to do, maybe not my next video, but the following, is kind of go through my whole setup, how I display my cards, and all the different things I've got displayed down in my man room / card room. Other than that, I hope you all have a great night. Thanks for hanging out with me. Thanks for watching. I appreciate you guys watching the videos, and we'll see you soon.